Electron microscopy is, instead of using light to look at samples, we take it to the next step and use electrons. The light microscope has been around for a few hundred years, and it was not until the 1930s they realized that you could get higher resolution by using electrons rather than light. It was actually started to be commercially viable within the 40s and has been used ever since. Now, electrons, when they're fired from the filament at the top of the microscope, they pass down the column, but electrons can't travel through air, so all of the air molecules will deflect the electrons and you wouldn't get an electron beam. So the whole microscope has to be kept at high vacuum constantly, 24 hours a day, every day.
And for all of the reasons that Pippa's described, it's very difficult to put a biological sample into an electron microscope. If we went into space without protection, then we would implode or explode or boil, which is going to happen to cells if you put them into a vacuum. So we protect them in resin. Biological samples are made of carbon and hydrogen and oxygen, and they don't have much contrast in the electron microscope. So we use heavy metals, things like osmium and lead and uranium, and all of those bind to the membranes in cells and tissues. And so when the electrons hit them, then they scatter, and we can produce an image in the microscope. We have to cut the resin block extremely finely. The only thing that's sharp enough to do that is a specially sharpened diamond. And those sections then have to be moved around the water and separated. And that's done by something very cheap, which is our own eyelash stuck to a cocktail stick.
There is another way that we can prepare samples. We can cryostabilize. We have to freeze that sample, freeze that water incredibly quickly, so about 1,000,000 degrees a second, from liquid state into a glass-like solid state.
We now have microscopes here which will run automatically for several months, and they can generate terabytes of data. There are more than 100 labs at the Crick, and we work with around 60 of them every year on around 100 different projects.
Every time we look down the microscope, we're discovering something new, and they're incredibly beautiful.
It's just a whole different world.
Hallelujah moment.
Picture speaks 1,000 words, as they say.